XLM, we start with 1 hour chart. We want to see how we can look for trade. As we can see, after we get this correction, the price dropped. Even we mentioned we want to see the one more drop with the breakout of this low. And exactly this is what we get. And if you refer to the indicators, we see we have a divergence. That's why if we get any trade set of buy, this is what we're looking for. And even we can put this one as an internal flat. All right, that means for now, if we get any buy, this is what we're looking for. But beside that, if we move to higher time frame, we move to daily chart, as we can see the price drop. And this is the things we mentioned, we can expect the price to consolidate here for a longer time before we get the reversal. And if we move to forward chart, what we have here, we have this flat. That's why when the price was within this move, I was keep highlighting about the flat. Either the price drop, retest the previous low, or deeper correction. Okay, now, we want to see how deep it can go, whether the price can retest the previous low or not, okay? Or we can put this one as a correction in relative to this. First of all, if you put over FIB here, in relative to this, the price drop almost to 61%. That means from now, if we get any trade for buy, this is what we are more interested. Do we need to wait for the price to retest this low before we take the trade for buy or not? For me, if I get any reversal from now, I will take the trade. Okay, because technically when we see this kind of the flat, we can expect the price to retest this low. But since most of the charts, they have a similar movement, they flow in each other, then we don't need to wait. If we see any trade for buy based on lower time frame, we take the trade. But based on forward chart, we cannot refer to the indicators unless the price drop to 0.2727 cents. Okay, that's why we have to trade. The best thing is if we trade based on 1 hour chart. First of all, we don't have any correction here. That means right now we cannot look for either buy or sell. If there is a continuation, mostly we can expect to get the small correction and continuation. This kind of the trade is a short term. That's why we don't add in on our analysis. That's why in this analysis, we're looking for reversal. That means if you get any trade set up for buy, this is what we're looking for. And beside that, even if you get the trade for buy, I don't think this is the one is going to retest this top. That means if we get the buy, maybe this one give us a bigger correction. That's why we should have the proper management if we get the trade setup for buy. Anyway, as I mentioned, we don't have any trade setup. And right now we have a divergence. And right now we're looking for reversal. This is what we are more interested to look for. In this case, we just follow the chart. If I see any update, I will share. And whoever get the trade for sell from here, right now, if they want to keep the trade, at least move their stop loss to break even. Anyway, we just follow the chart. If I see any update, I will share. Thanks.